Hello everyone. If you can hear me and see me, please write a yes and then we will start with our session today. Am I audible? Hello, Sahej. Hello, Padmita. If my audio and video is clear, please write a yes so that we can start with the work for today. Okay, thank you, Padmita. Good. Okay, everyone. We started with our Gondi series. We all know about it. And now today, somebody requested me to do the tree of life or how the trees are made, because that is a major part of the Gond art. So we will do that. Hello everyone. Very good. We all are here again. Okay. So starting with the Gond art, the introduction and other things I have all discussed in my previous videos. And those who have not viewed it, please go and check that. Now today we are going to start with the tree, how to make a tree. This is a major element of all the Gond art. Either animals, people, birds, whatever we make the tree. So the tree, the leaves, they are there, roots, branches going, flourishing everywhere, wildly, wild spread of trees. So when you will see the tree, you will see that the leaves are there, and the roots are extended, branches go vast and can be like huge paintings with tree element. So that is the major portion of it, because no matter what subject we take, it revolves around the forest. That is a major role to play with the paintings. Now today I have taken an A5 size, a slightly bigger, and today I will just put it on my table. And I will show you what all stuff we need for today's drawing. This is a paper here, and I will be drawing my rough sketch with a pencil, and everything will be freehand. Freehand, as in when we talk about freehand, it's not about that you do not have to use your pencil and eraser. You have to directly go. No, it's not like that. When we talk about freehand, we do not have any tracing. Tracing is not involved, any transferring is not involved, whatever, the paper is blank and we will be starting with your own idea. Okay. And as you all know, nothing is planned before, because I incorporate all of you into the drawing, the color suggestions, whatever. So everybody is a part of what I do. So this paper is here, and I have taken this time, it's an acrylic sheet. Acrylic sheets are hard and a little more thick, more than 300 GSM. So this is a thicker sheet and it is a 400 GSM, known as the acrylic sheet. So if you do not want to do, if you want to actually do heavy watercolor or anything, or acrylic paints, this paper will give you a good hold on paper, on paints. So I'll just take my pencil and we will start with the drawing. Just take a regular pencil and keep an eraser handy for any mistakes that you might make or any changes that might come up right away. Thank you. Good afternoon, everybody. Please feel yourself welcome here. And I might not be able to address each and everybody of you, but yes, you are a part of our group. So whatever suggestions, if I see any questions and while I'm doing the art, I might skip. Please re-type your question so that I can revert it back. So here I will be making a tree, as was said, and I'll make a bird. So bird, those who have not subscribed, I've just hit a subscribe button to support me. And thank you for those who are already with me on this. So here, not here, I'll just take it a little lower. I'm going to do a wing here. I'm doing a little bigger bird. The paper size that I've taken is slightly bigger than A5 size paper. It's not A4, it's a little smaller. So this is a wing here. This is the face. This is the body here. You can just go random what you want to make. So I would just rather not make it that curve because it's giving a very different look. I'll just make it little. And then making a foot over here. And this foot gets transformed into the other foot is here. And these 2 foot of the feet of the bird. And here the tail goes to be the a little part of the trunk, and then the bottom, which is the roots. So let's see how it gets transformed here. So just random, we can just go random and make the branches. You may not copy this altogether, the branch system, because I'm just going wherever comfortably I can set my branches. So this is one tree system that's going over here. I would do a sub branch which hides a little of the head also. So you can branch your tree wherever you want it to be. So here, this part. So I'm just covering the all the sides of it. And this is the next foot. So rough part is ready. Hi, my tree. Hello. And here, I'll not make any sections. So just went with the flow of this. Make a big eye, and in the center, I'm making a this kind of a eye. So it shows that it's kind of a lid. Now this side there's one wing, and I will go ahead and make the wing on the other side also, which is halfway hidden the bottom. So this is another wing. You just have the bird full. This is one wing, this is the other side, this is the tail that gets transformed to the roots. So again, the roots I will make, they are also the branch system. Like the branch system, we also do this. They are just the same. You may put anything over here, like if I happen to, any suggestions, what should I place here? You can just pop in your suggestions as well, like we'll make it instantly. But here, any animal, a cow or anything, can be down here as well if you do not want to make this like this. So let's make something then, because branch system, we will be doing it here. I'll just make one animal also here. Let's see. And it is all free flow, so you need not plan your picture very method the method of doing is whatever you want to show first. If in case you have an idea towards it, what you have to show, good enough. Ears and the horns, and this is so just giving it a rough. You might not be very calculative about this, and so not many curves, not many. The real picture wouldn't be involved. Like just the imagery is good to support your picture. And here I will just go ahead and give the root wherever possible. I'll make the tail for this. So this, with this, we are just ready with the outline of the picture. We will start with our paints now, and I will be taking my acrylic paints. So I have sorted all the all sorts of paints. Different shades are there, and we will do the bird first. I will be laying just the color in Gond art. Only the base colors are to be done first, and all the detailing goes next. So we will start with the colors of the base. I'll just keep all of it aside, all my paints, whatever I have, and then we will go one by one with it. You can use also your tube colors or your bottled colors, whatever you want to use, you can use it. I'm using acrylic tube black, and I will be mixing it with white for the branches. So this part of it will be a little dull, while the bird will be a little more bright. So I'm taking my black and white to make the gray for the branches. Take white as the base and then gradually add black to it. I'm just adding little, and I will stop where I get my desired shade, because a little black goes a long way. So I'll just mix a little, and you may have to add a little bit of water if in case your color is too thick. Here, this is a shade. You will get to know it when I'll be doing it on the paper. So now here, I might not choose my lines because it was roughly drawn. I'll just go with the flow of the paint. So I'll not trace it down, and I suggest you also don't do that. That's much quicker and faster way of doing your. See to it that your paint is nice and smooth. A lot depends on the paper that you take. Sometimes the paper won't be smooth. If you want a very smooth painting, you can go for a smoother textured paper. So here, this branch is ready. I will go and do all of them with this gray. So I just press and release and go down. Wherever it is meeting the branch, the main branch, it will go a little thick. So yeah, if in case you have those lines popping out, just use an eraser later to erase it. Now here, I plan to leave this branch because this is a part of the bird. I might do it in a different color. Only the ends I will do it with gray. The lines should be crisp, so I'm just touching the ends where I have actually got a little frayed. I'll retouch and fix the line. And I'm shifting the paper because that paper side is wet. So anybody who's working with me right now can type a yes, so that I get to see that how many of you are enjoying and how many, which color you apply. Okay, Ranjita, I'm applying a gray. I just talked about that we have to take white as a base and then I'm applying gray. I made it with my black and white mixing of it. And it's acrylic paint. Hello, everyone. Okay, so we are done with this part. And here, this root system, I will do it in a different color. I will do the branch. You may not take the real colors, like if in case the root is white, you may not do white. You want to choose a different brighter color. You can go and have your own color play. These paintings are known for its vibrance and vividness in colors. So there's a whole lot of variety that you will find in these pictures. The colors will change. They will be very bright and they will be, they might not follow the same trick. Like the bird is not only one color, it will be multiple colors. So I'll go ahead and do the wing first because that's the major front of the picture. And any suggestions you can give it to me. I prefer doing a little different from what we have done, the color choice in our previous ones. So I'll take a very dark maroon color. I have a maroon color here. And yes, that's maroon 14. And I will do the center of this. It's a very bright and a very deep color. So I just imagine that when I'll be doing the design over it, how beautiful it will come. And these sheets that I'm telling, the acrylic sheets, they're very smooth and very, your paint glides very easily over there. So always give it a try. Different textured paper, different tools, different paints, different mediums. It's always helpful. So I just painted it and then I'm just rubbing off any of the strokes that I might see. And this is the paint here. It is shining, reflecting in the camera, but it is a maroon shade, very dark maroon. I will do the same for the other one over here. The color altogether and the texture that I'm getting from this paper feels as if I'm painting my nails. Okay, so we are done with this portion here, and this is the bird. Any questions anybody has, please type in. Okay. Okay. Now going for the choice of the bird, I will take a very different color. I'll be mixing the color to find that balance in it. I'll take orange. Any of the shades, be it just the original that you get in the bottle, or if you want to mix a little, you may mix it. So here I'm taking orange and I will be mixing it with white and yellow to get a little peachy color. Which number brush? Which number brush actually depends on how big is your painting. For what I have chosen, I'm just taking a brush which is around number 4. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you, thank you. So if you are doing it on the canvas or any big picture or any A4 size or A3 size, then you will definitely go with a flatter and a bigger brush tip. Whatever, if in case you are doing the thin areas, you can go with a thinner brush. So it totally depends on what your area you are doing. Sometimes people have that, even for the beginners, I would suggest, they have the tendency of bending the brush. When they put a lot of pressure on the brush, it totally depends whether the tip you are using, you will get fine lines. If you are using the whole body of the whole volume of the brush by pressing it, it will get flattened and then you will get little broader lines. So then it is very easy for you to know the area and how nicely you can cover it. Do not take a very thin brush for the bigger areas because it will take a lot of time. Point one, and the second is that you might get strokes also because one part kind of dries, and then so you might get a little lines. I'll just take a little yellow also, so I'll just add it in front of you. So here is the color. I took a little bit of white, I took a little bit of orange, and I took a little bit of yellow. So these are the three colors, and let's see what happens. What color? So here it's really light and peachy color because then if I am using a very dark color, I will go for a contrasting color so that the bird comes out really bright. So here, this very beautiful shade. You may choose your own shade. There's no hard and fast rule that you have to go with the choice, my choice, whatever I'm doing. Okay, so I'll go with the area here. Just doing my outlines. I'll leave this leg. And when I go in the middle, you'll see that I press it a little. So I don't mind if my bristles go a little flat and covers a wider area. Because when I load my brush, the bristles has been loaded all the way up with the paint. So better that I use all of it. So I'm just pressing it gently to get that paint out, squeezed out, and then I'm just rubbing it off to cover that area. Now, once everything is wet, I'll just rub it off to get the fine, smooth paint on the areas. Reload your brush once it is all exhausted. Here and okay, how about I go with this? This is a very friendly color for the root system as well. And I have faith. I'll go ahead and do it. This way, few of them are sticking out from the corner, and I'll do the same. You can extend, even if it is not drawn, if I want some extensions, I'm just extending it a little. So, how much ever you want to spread your roots. So, I'm spreading my roots, the face. So, here. Thank you, Kirti. Thank you so much. So this portion is done, and I want a really pop of color, a really pop of color in this, which is not very dark, not very light. So we will take that for this. Now, coming to the tree, once I think everything is dried, yes, it is. Now I will add few leaves and some colorful fruits. So I can go ahead and do the leaf. You may or may not choose a green color for your leaf. It is totally fine. If you do not want to abide by the all leaves are green, you can just eliminate that and you can do any other color. Here I'll do a beautiful color. Let me just pull out of the colors and see. Any suggestions, you can just give it to me. Any suggestions what you think? Really bright and peppy. I feel I could do it with yellow. What you guys think? You let me know. Where is my yellow? So here is yellow. And I'm not drawing any of those. I will go freehand with red. Red will be a little too much because this is also red. Okay, I'll do few red. Okay, few reds will do. So here I'll just check my brush is clean. Yes, it is. And then I'll go ahead with yellow. Yellow and red, of course, I'll do red also. So I am going freehand. If you want to draw it first, you may. So I'm just going it like this and I'm turning it like a water drop, and that's how I make the leaf. And generally, I am putting that in the intersection. So intersection is the inside area where it is. So I'm just making it like a drop. Like this. You may vary the shape or the turn of it, like here it is a little going towards the top. You can have them pointed. Mostly this tree symbolizes the Mahua tree. Mahua tree, we find a lot of Mahua tree in that region of Madhya Pradesh and pockets of surrounding region. And Mahua tree is considered, for them, it is considered as the tree of life, because the fruit, the tribes generally take out the juice of it and make various drinks. So that way it is celebrated, it is worshipped. And they consider that it has a spirit. All the trees, they have spirits. So we generally, knowing living and non-living things came very late. People had that notion that all the elements of life, be it water, air, hills, mountains, they all have life and spirits. So if the rain is there, they are superstitious and they believe that there's something wrong. So those beliefs, we have studied also what their thinking is. But apart from all of that, they believe that they have powers. Even the hills, the mountains, they have powers. And those powers they consider as spirits. Sometimes good spirits, sometimes bad spirits. So if everything is going favorable to them, it is a good spirit. If things are not going favorable, then it is a bad spirit. The same element can cause good or bad effects. So that is the main reason they prayed, all the tribes, they prayed the forces of nature, to be very specific. Forces of nature, the wind, the sun, the moon, they were all prayed and worshipped. So here, looks like I'm filling too much of yellow, and I still have the suggestion in mind that went that I should be doing red. I will go and do a few of them red. So here, but yes, let's take red as well. Few. And the red could be a little circles. So red is actually different, very much different from this maroon. Maroon is, if you do not have maroon, just you can make maroon with by adding a little bit of black to your red. That gives the tonal quality and makes the tone of the color dark. So here I have this, and I will be making few of the red ones. Wow, beautiful. Nice suggestion. Orange, Maitri, okay. So here, we're just doing red. So my paint is a little less. It's okay. Thank you to you for suggesting the color. Okay, here, just it's always a curiosity to see how the patterns are going to build on this color, lighter colors, darker colors. So, and it's always very experimental. So making few reds is actually giving it a very brighter look. You may also do it green, or if you want to just follow the. So here, I don't have much place to do red, so I feel that this should be okay. Yeah, pretty good. So now for here, I will be for this now. This is there. What should I do? Shall I be taking gray? Would be nice if I take gray. It'll be balancing the picture because there's too much of a gray on the top. So let's take gray, or rather a little darker version of gray. And I can do it in parts. Which bird is that? We don't specify the birds in the tribal pictures, or because the birds are just the birds. They are the images that just showing that a bird. So they are depicting their own clan. So we cannot specify that this is which bird. Maybe a parrot, or definitely not a sparrow, not a pecking bird. It's a bigger one. It's a big bird with big. This big talons, and it's a bigger bird. So that's it, pretty much. So it's not specified. Whereas if you make smaller size, the size depends. So here is my Facebook account. Those who have not are not following, I would suggest you follow anujaart.in, because most of the things and the classes, you will get the notifications from there. What the classes are running, not the YouTube thing, but the private classes that are running for different age groups and different skill sets. So here I will just change the color. I'll make it in a double tone. So I suggest you follow that as well. The link of it will be given in the description box also. And here I'll take a very subtle color, a purple. Where are my colors? I'll take a brown or an orange. What do you suggest, everybody? Beautiful word. Thank you, Nirmala. Any suggestions for what color should go with gray? Any color is okay. Any suggestions? So, how about yellow? Anybody? Nobody's typing in. Okay, orange. Pratiksha, orange I think will be too much, because this is also orange. Or let me take a brighter one. So here we are done with major parts. I'll go with a altogether a different color. Nobody's suggesting that color. I just happen to have it. New color for me. So here, let's see how it comes. It's blue. We do not happen to see a blue bull. Here, I'm just painting the base. The color is very, very transparent and liquid. I might have to do the second coat for this. Here, this is done. I will wait for it to dry, and then I will be doing the second coat. I'll take the darker gray for the ear. And I'll leave the horns right that. Yes, it's light blue. Okay, so this part is done. I'll take a really bright color, in fact, the red itself, and do the tail of this. we are done with the basic color play here, and this foot part is left. I will leave it white. I will show you a different trick for these two places where I have done only left it white. Now I'll just close these things. I hope you all can catch me till here. Thank you. Okay. So here now we can do intricacy or the line pattern. You can do it with any pen. If in case you have a black gel pen, you can work with black gel pen. You have to just only see that you do not scratch the paint, because this paint, when we are doing it on a very smooth surface, sometimes, like if you are doing it on a plastic or anything or any surface, then you might scratch it when you use very pointed nibs, and so you have to control your pressure. What color is the eagle's wing? Oh, the one which I did is maroon. This is maroon, this one is, but it's a big bird. I do not categorize this as it is an eagle. So here, and I will be taking my black ink, or rather I can take the pens, different pens with different thickness. We'll be doing it with ink also. I'm taking my microns, and my microns are of different thickness. Here I'm taking a 0.5 to do the major divisions of the branch. So just going it in a wavy pattern. So wherever you want to go comfortably, I'm just, the pattern will get slowly built up with more lines. So here, a small section. I'll lower the camera so that a little better view will come. So here I'm just doing one side. I'm just doing this pattern, and you can go intricate and make the broken lines here. So here, if I hold it close, it's very, very, probably now it's focusing. So it's like two lines and then a ladder in the middle. And I'll go alternate in the color. So here I took this. And the other side, I'm taking another pen in white. I'm doing the same trick there. So when you look at this portion, you will see that though the background is just one color, the tree will have two different colors popping out. So one portion will appear with texture and little lighter gray. because of the color that is showing up from the middle of the design. The pen that I'm using today is a Signo, Uniball Signo, and the thickness of it is 0.7. If you do not have this, you may also use your white nib, nib and a white acrylic paint to do the design, or your brush also. So here we'll do this pattern. These paintings really take time. So depending on how minute work you do, these will take time, but they are very satisfying. All the folk arts in the sense, they are very, very beautifully done. Now we just have the privilege of all these things which are there available on the counter, these easy pens. But the time when people used to paint their walls with just a stick or a twig, it is, or a matchstick, it is so difficult. It's a big task. So while I started doing the Gond art, I have all the respect for those artists who just gave their lives for this, dedicated their lives to this art form. So this is one branch which came out beautifully. If you can just view it here, this is, otherwise you will be able to view it as a thumbnail once it gets completed. Now I'm making the same leaf pattern. I'm dividing the leaf, the red leaf, and making these small lines like the vein system of the tree, of the leaf here. For the yellow ones, I can just make myself a little halfway to give only the top curve to this. So there are two different types. So in this picture, there is nothing like a stroke, very loose stroke. Each and every line is done very, very consciously. And with a proper hold, like from the beginning till the end, you can never go loose with the line. Making any of the tree painting is a big task because this white color is waterproof. Yeah, it's quite permanent. Yeah, but waterproof, these are not waterproof pens. These are gel, white gels. This pen that I'm using is a waterproof pen. It says it's waterproof and it's fade proof and it has finer lines. You can also do it with a black gel pen. That is okay, because now what has to be waterproof is the basic color which is down there. If we happen to do this with a poster color, then what will happen when we are using our paints on the top, the poster color will blend with the water and you might not get very crisp lines. Padmaja, okay, we have Artful Studio Workshop Facebook group also. You can share it there. Otherwise, you can message me on my Facebook page and I will direct you where you can place your paintings. So those who are here and those who want to showcase their stuff, we have a group also. That is a Facebook group, and it is Art Thrill Studio Workshops. Exactly. It's any artwork. Basically, when you get engaged into anything, like as someone said, it's very meditative. It is indeed, because once we start to do anything, our mind gets into the art or anything. For few, running, jogging, exercising, singing, anything could be very meditative because it has positive effects on your health and your mind. So if in case that is solving the purpose, definitely. Whatever relaxes a soul, for few, for especially me also, art is very, very relaxing. I feel very restless when I don't do anything in my art. Sure, Kirti. Those who want to share, the link has been posted there. And you can post your work there. You may also pass it to others who feel they want to join the groups, and thereby we will share our art. Here. This will take a little more time. I will just show two and then we will switch on to the bird. So alternately, I'm putting this texture so that the gray is visible. And now the picture is turning out to be not very pale. It's not just one color in the base. It is showing the texture also and the shade. One side it is shining a dark gray and the other side it is the light gray. I will post the final picture as a thumbnail on this, and we will switch on to the bird. You may share this workshop with others who you think might be interested. Now here, going on to this part, I will be making the dots with a different color because this is a very dull dark color, so the contrast will be with a little bright one. I'll take my very fine brush. If you have to make dots, take a very fine brush. Or the liner brush. The liner brushes are different in a sense. They have longer bristles and very pointed. So here, I'm doing yellow scallop design here. With the brush. So it isn't, it's not that if you do not have the pen, you won't be able to do your work. You can do it with the brush. But this needs a little balance. You have to concentrate more because it is brush. And you do not have to press it too much. Just use the tip to make fine lines. poster colors for the painting. Manasa, I told you this before as well. If you want to use poster colors, then only use pen on the top. If you happen to do your lines with water and again poster color at a base and poster color lines, if you will work with a little bit of more water, you might blend it a little. So suppose if I have done this red maroon with poster color and then I'm doing yellow, pretty good chances that my maroon will come in yellow also, because at poster color, when it is wet, it will again be worked on, so it doesn't dry permanent. The anytime you put water, ma'am, can we use toothpick? Yes, you may use toothpick or any pointed object as well. People back then only used those things, the twigs from the trees. We just switch to the material that is according to our suitability and we can do things faster. But I will be showing it to you with all the things, whatever you want to take. Because if you are using it on the canvas, big canvases, if you are making, you will have to use your brush. Okay, Pratiksha, we have already, if you are new, we have already done a lot of workshops so far, and all the workshops are like full tutorials. We did our Madhubani, Warli, and Sora, and now we are doing Gond art. After Gond art, we will start with few of the and the mandala too. I have few things in the mandala that will be taken care of after this as well, and we will go to different art forms. Like kalamkari and patachitra, those also will be covered. All the folk arts of India will be covered, and later all the tribal arts from international also I would be doing it, like for the Aboriginal art or the African art, we will be doing that as well. So those who have not subscribed, I wish you subscribe. Please share the workshops with others so they all can be benefited. So here, this whole thing is completed like this, and I will go and make the other one also the same. You may also use the, if you are not very comfortable with using the brush and you feel that your lines are not coming proper, then I would show you. You get jelly roll pens, and the jelly roll pens are all in all colors. So you can, that is very handy if you want to use. I have jelly roll pen here as well. I'll show you a few. Like this, you will get in different colors. Just to show one, maybe of this little orange. And here I will just make the dots on the sides. So this, it depends on how detailed you want to be. The more detail, definitely it is better. Good. Otherwise, we can also go ahead and make just dashes. That is a very common and the staple thing of this art form. So here I'm just putting these dots. And this is with a jelly roll pen. So that makes it a little easier and faster. But no way I would say that if you do not have it, you cannot do it. You can use your brush to do the dots and they will come equally beautiful. I might show you just one part of the wing, and the other part I will be posting it once completed so that you will have the idea. Otherwise, we will be taking a lot of time here. So the patterns, those who have not seen the pattern page, which was the first class, class one, that didn't happen live, but but it is posted as a tutorial. Just check that as well. There are a lot many patterns and we are doing different patterns. How to put them in the picture that we will be doing it in bigger paintings. Yeah, and we are close to the completion of this feather. Please take Chitara art. Okay. Only deer. Okay, sure. We will do deer as well. I noted it down. My three wants to learn deer. There is one painting that I'm working on, and that has a beautiful deer in it. It's a Madhubani painting, but yeah, it's still work in progress. So once it is done, you will have the tutorial on the channel. That is from the Madhubani series, but yeah, it has deer. But I'll tell you how to make the deer in the Gondi art as well. This one and taking the jelly roll, just brightening it up a little more. So when you see these gone pictures from a distance, it gives you the 3D effect of the feather. Now, as we see, we will see that yes, it is coming out, and otherwise it was just a blank. So the design is not done before, like in the Madhubani painting, we make all the double lines, they are pre-decided, they are well planned, thought of, whereas in Gond, it is all developed later. Over the paint. So here, oh, I missed one here. Did I miss any? No, I got it. So this is one which is done, and this I will be completing later. We'll just go ahead and do our bird over here. Now, as I said, different things can be done. Here I have the waterproof ink also and the nib. That's one of my favorites. Those who follow me know that none of my paintings are complete without it. I like the thickness, the brightness of this. So it's really bright and popping out. I'm giving the a dotted effect on the beak, though it's not very visible in the camera because of the distance. Now here, this place I left to show the texture. How do I do the dotting in this? Not necessary that you would just do the design. There are many artists who use only dots. So I'm just putting random dots. This is also one of a very contemporary way of shading, and you do not have to put the dots in a measured or just go with your estimation. Wherever you want to make the shade darker, then you have to apply the dense dots, and wherever you want to make it go a little lighter, it will go scanty. This can be done on the white base also or on the color as well. So if I would have colored the foot here, this piece here, it would have come with the shade in the color. But here, I just took the white paper, and here this side it is a little scanty. If you happen to do it on a cloth, take fabric paints, Fevicryl fabric paints, they are good, and you can work with that. With very fine cloth, you can also use your nib. Many people ask me that can we use the nib for Madhubani or any art form on the cloth? Yes, you may use it. You have to use a reasonable pressure, not too much, otherwise you might tear the paper, the cloth if it's a very delicate silk or anything. Else you can go with your liner brushes for very thin. Now here I'm just going a little dense on the top, which will give me a little darker effect. This is I'm repeating this. I did this in my previous video also, but doing it live without any editing, it really shows how much time it takes. So there is no forwarding, no shifting, and this is how this thing comes. The same thing can be done for the horn of the bowl here. Now here, I'm going and doing the partition on the face. Here, and I would do it in two colors because generally we see that the top of the head. Can we use normal fountain pen ink? Yes, you may use it. But as compared to this ink, you have to check in a sample whether it is bleeding or not. Sometimes that gets too runny. And those who want to make their own inks, how to make their own inks? If you have these paints already with you, you can make your own ink also. There is a video which says best nibs and ink for Madhubani, but the same ink can be used for our Gond art as well. So, taking the brush. And this time the blue color. So you can check that video, and that will help you with all the types of nibs. What all nibs can you use, fountain pen or not, which and how if in case you do not have the ink or the waterproof ink. We do get camel waterproof ink, but if in case you do not want to buy it, it's totally okay. There is a consistency test that we have to do. How thick our paint should be, or how what is the consistency for our ink? How flowy or not what? Then you may check that and you can make your own inks with your paints, acrylic paints. Now, this is indeed very meditative, but it requires a lot of patience also. If you want to go really fast and you make your dashes a little far or not dense, the look will definitely change. But yes, it is a gone heart. You can follow the same depending on your wish. I'll just show you how the dense looks here. Stippling art. Okay. Stippling art is basically pointillism. And yes, why not? We can do that. That is a very contemporary form, pop art, stippling, pointillism. Here and now I'm going with white. So when I apply white, you will see that the color totally changes and it becomes a little lighter. So there are two shades that are there. Now this area I'm doing it a little scanty in the sense, not very close. Use nib on canvas. Yes, you may use nib on canvas, but when I use my nib on canvas, I need to prime my canvas very well so that the canvas is not very rough. So always prime your canvas if you are doing your dots, because even for the dotting mandalas, the workshop that I took, if you happen to do your dots on the canvas, you will feel that the texture that the canvas has, if you see it very close, then your dots get a little distorted. Distorted in the sense they might lose that perfect shape of a pearl. So in that way, you'll have to just prime it a little and it'll be good enough. So just prime your canvas, or whenever you're buying it, see to it that it is well primed and it is a good quality. So the tooth of the canvas is not very coarse. We also get linen canvas. So linen canvas, the grain of the canvas will be, the texture of the canvas will be very smooth if it is with the linen. It's not with the canvas because canvas is rough. Here I will be doing the body of this kettle. Next week also we will continue with the art form of Gond, and we will go ahead and tell you about how to make about the human figures and why are they made, how are they made, what is the general form of this. Any other videos or tutorials that you want, you can just write it to me on Gond art, because we are just doing it with the Gond art series right now. If you have any recommendations, like what should be taught to you, just write it to me. Just making small half circles. You may not go very calculative on it. just giving the curves to show that the tail is rounded. You may also do the pointillism with your pen. Anything that you can make your points with. Cow only, Gond art, okay. Sure. Doing the wavy pattern to cover the wider area. This here, I will go ahead and do the same on this time in an angle. This is a small pattern. I will do brighten the red leaves with dot. And this is how we will be finishing our picture. The same patterns that we have done for two branches goes for all the branch. The patterns that we have done for the leaf will be just the same for all. And the skin, the bird is complete and the picture goes like this. We'll continue it. How to prime the canvas? We do the priming with the gesso. And with you may see I you may do two coats of gesso and lightly sand your work. If you do two coats of gesso and lightly sand your canvas, it gets a very smooth texture. And if in case you want to do it on a wood panel or anything, just do it the priming with a gesso or and then sand it off a little to with a fine, very fine sandpaper, and you will get very glassy finish, and then you can do your paintings. Yes, Pratiksha, you can ask the question. Yes. Yes, any questions? Anybody who wants to ask any question may ask while I'll try to answer all of your questions. and then we will end. I will post the final outcome of this picture on the as a thumbnail of this tutorial. We also get super fine textured canvas. For glass painting, I never do the gesso, because for glass painting I use the glass. The beauty of the glass painting is when it is only done on the glass with no gesso. So the transparency of the color is very important. Thank you everyone. How much is the price for the jelly roll? You can just browse and see. I really don't know. I have it all loose and the packet has been thrown, so I don't know how much the cost of it will be. So I have loose pens, but yeah, white jelly roll comes around 100 bucks or 70-80, I don't know. Within 100 you will get it, just one pen. Okay, so thank you everyone, and for any doubts that you might have, or any difficulties, or any suggestions that you feel that you want these, you may write it in the comments and I will revert it back to you. Okay. Okay, so I'll see you next week at the same time with another tutorial, probably on Gond art, how to make the human figures and what is the relevance of it. So stay connected with me and keep watching.